This is Duane Friend with University of Illinois Extension. We live in an ocean of air. That ocean of air moves, and we feel that movement as wind. What makes the wind? The answer is because of differences in air pressure. Air has mass or weight. In fact, at sea level, every square inch of area has almost 15 pounds of force being exerted on it due to this mass. However, that force can vary slightly. One reason it varies is because of temperature. When temperatures are warmer, air expands, becomes less dense, and rises, decreasing air pressure. Colder temperatures cause air to sink and compress, increasing air pressure. Other factors can make air rise or sink, and this can also cause high and low air pressure. With low air pressure, air is rising. To replace the rising air, more air from the surrounding area must come in to replace it. Sinking air, associated with high pressure, will spread out. So, air will flow from high to low pressure, creating wind. Without other factors, air would flow directly from high to low pressure. However, on Earth, that doesn't exactly happen. Because the Earth spins, that motion is also given to the wind. This is called the Coriolis effect. North of the equator, this causes winds to move in a counterclockwise motion into low pressure and move in a clockwise motion away from high pressure. Besides the little highs and lows you see on a weather map, there are large bands of high and low pressure across the Earth. In turn, this causes large bands of prevailing winds to be present across the Earth's surface. These are also affected by the spin of the Earth. In the northern hemisphere, near the equator, winds come from the northeast and are called the northeast trades. Halfway between the equator and the North Pole, winds come out of the west and are called the westerlies. Near the North Pole, winds come out of the east again and are called the polar easterlies. Where do you live on Earth, and what direction does your weather come from? You'll notice that it will be mostly controlled by what major band of winds you're in. When you look at a weather map, see where the highs and lows are located and see what direction the winds are coming out of where you are at. These smaller pressure areas will also affect wind direction on a more local basis.